Hello everyone, it's JOANNAMARQUET here, Lemon Creation, and today I have a project for you with distress oxides and Maremi Small Art digital papers, which are super cool, and I just wanted to make something something funny with it. So thank you for staying tuned. For this project, I'm using my homemade or handmade art journal with these ones are, I think, if I'm not mistaken, watercolor papers. So I took it out like that. I can put it on the flat surface and it doesn't bother me that there were already some pages done and they can be bulky and so like that. I can do whatever I want on the completely flat surface. And I'm gonna be doing my background, and it's gonna be a kind of messy background because I'm using distress oxides. So as you can see, I'm putting them on a piece of acetate, I don't know if it's acetate foil or just acetate. And the reason for doing so is that, you know, acetate bends in any direction you want, so you can and you can see through. So you can kind of move your paint the way you want. You can also do it with acrylic block, but acrylic block will not bend so easily. So, you know, you will have much less control over what you're putting on the page. And as you see, I am adding different colors. I am kind of smudging it, you know, looking for the best arrangement for the page. I'm drying it a little bit. I don't even bother that much because later I'm gonna spray a little bit of water to get the oxide effect, and so it really doesn't bother me that, you know, first layer or first color is not totally dry. I continue, and I added, I think, three colors like that. Yes, three colors, and later I'm gonna be adding the fourth color, but with the stencil. It's very probable that I may not add the list of products used in the description box below this time because I am visiting my parents-in-law, and I'm actually out of home, and I don't want to I don't have that much time. Actually, I want to spend the time I have with the family, but as you can see, I froze the screens for you so you can see all the products I used. And now I'm using one of the stencils of Marta Łapkowska, Maremi Small Art. I wanted to make this page really with her products mostly. And anyway, I love the stencil, and I thought that I'm gonna get a little bit more texture, more funny things, more funny vibes to this page by using it. So I'm just kind of, you know, smudging it with the sponge applicator all over the page. Not even all over the page, in the places I see fit, in the places I see that there is something missing and that the stencil will be actually really visible. But that is always up to you. And as you can see now, I am sprinkling the page with water. I'm using Mini Mister. You can use any spray bottle you want, but Mini Mister has, as I said time and again, it has a very concentrated, you know, a splash, or so, you know, it doesn't go all over the page. It's just concentrate more, more or less in one place. And of course, you can also use it or sprinkle with water, like with a brush, or as I'm doing right now. And it depends on the time of drying. With oxide, you're gonna get the oxide effect, and the intensity of it, it depends on the time of drying it. So you can leave it so it dries all by itself, you're gonna have different effect. You can dry it with the heat gun, you're gonna get a different effect, or you can just wipe it with the tissue and also gonna get different effects. And to finish my background off, I'm using Marta's stamps, the flower ones, because as you see later with the focal point, I wanted to kind of do a, you know, background kind of foresty. So that's why the flowers and, you know, the green color. And I absolutely love the fact that the flowers are not, for once I didn't use black ink, and I used the green one. And I like that, you know, they are kind of melting into the background, but yet they are still visible. the stamping is very clear, so you know they are there, and like that, that's just, you know, it's not very striking, the effect of stamps which I use for this project, but it's there. And I use a little bit of, I did a little bit of splatter with water soluble oil pastels. And now, as I'm showing you, I'm using Marta's digital papers. So the whole idea was to make something funny. I don't know if it's super funny, my page finally, but I love it because, you know, there is this huge mushroom and there is gonna be this tiny deer. So already the proportions are exaggerated, which is cool. And then the deer, unfortunately, will not have his backside. Because, as you will see later, I imagine it like that, that he is so tiny that he's actually managing to get hidden behind the, you know, the leg of the mushroom. And now I'm using my Posca marker to make some quite regular dots. So this is gonna be a kind of a, you know, mushroom which is not edible at all. I'm drying it, and then to make the dots even more you know, prominent, I'll add to them glossy accents. I am a huge fan of mushrooms, I have to tell you, and I remember when I was smaller, I was going with my parents to look for them in the forest, to pick them up in the forest, and I just kind of, I know different kinds of mushrooms, and I kind of thought that it would be really funny and more realistic maybe to add a little bit of crackle accents to the leg of the mushroom. That's what I just did, and I needed to leave it for a moment so it dries. It actually, the weather is very, very bad in France in general lately, especially at our place. There is a lot of storms and a lot of rain, and I had to leave it for a quite a long time. I wanted to finish the project before I go to my parents-in-law, but I couldn't manage because it was so, you know, humid. It was not drying at all. And I've done some tracing. I made a frame, I framed the page, but I decided that I want the frame to be more visible. So I kind of, in between those two frames I made, I kind of filled it up with the marker. So I have this, you know, wonky frame. And here is the end effect on the mushroom. I hope you can see quite well. There is a crackle accents, and there is glossy accents, which are like 3D drops, which works very nice. I was showing you here that I didn't cut properly between the ear of the deer. And now I'm gonna be just putting the things together, so basically adhering them to the one to the other and then to the page. And so that's what's happening in my imagination. A huge mushroom, small deer, who is so tiny that you cannot even see it from behind the leg of the mushroom. And to finish the page off, I'm gonna add a sentiment from my messy words, and I thought it's a funny sentiment for this page. And because the splatter I've done earlier on is not very visible, I decided to actually make a little bit more dots with the Unipin marker. And that would be all for that page. Please let me know what you thought or what you think about it, if you like the sentiment, if you like my idea of working with Marta's Digi Papers. And I wish you all who are on holidays a great holidays, For those of you who are not yet or not at all, I just wish you that you're gonna get some, you know, quality time. And I hope to see you soon in my next video. Bye bye!